हेलो एवरीवन, गुड मॉर्निंग स्टूडेंट्स. डियर स्टूडेंट्स, इन प्रीवियस क्लास वी टेक एंड डिस्कस अ वेरी इंपॉर्टेंट चैप्टर ऑफ योर सिलेबस विच इज इंट्रोडक्शन टू ट्रिग्नोमेट्रीज. एंड इन प्रीवियस क्लास वी डिस्कस अबाउट द टॉपिक ट्रिग्नोमेट्रिक आइडेंटिटीज. एंड इन दैट क्लास वी टेक एंड सॉल्व सम इम्पॉर्टेंट क्वेश्चन बेस्ड ऑन ट्रिग्नोमेट्रिक आइडेंटिटीज. नाउ इन टूडेज क्लास वी ऑल्सो टेक एंड सॉल्व सम अदर इम्पॉर्टेंट क्वेश्चन ऑफ योर of the chapter introduction to trigonometry based on trigonometric identities. So let's take and solve some important questions of yourselves. Your question is, prove
that sine to the power 6 theta plus sine to the power 6 theta plus cos to the power 6 theta is equal to 1 minus 3 sine square theta into cos square theta.
This is a very important question of your syllabus based on trigonometric identities. Let's see once. Your question is, we have to show that sine to the power 6 theta plus cos to the power 6 theta is equal to 1 minus 3 sine square theta into cos square theta. So what I do for that question? Dear student, first of all, let's see its solution, and we take the left hand side of this question, which is what? Sine power 6 theta plus cos power 6 theta. Now, what I do? Now here we apply the algebraic identities. We can write this question in this way also. We can write sine to the power 6 theta as sine square theta whole cube plus this is cos square theta whole cube. Okay. Now here we use the identities, since we know that a cube plus b cube is equal to, now we know that a cube plus b cube is equal to a plus b in one bracket and in another bracket a square plus b square minus ab. We know that
this
identity. Okay, now here we use that identity. Let's see here. This is the value of a is here sine square theta and b is what? Cos square theta. And this is the form of a cube plus b cube. So in first bracket we write a plus b. A plus b means what? Sin square theta plus cos square theta. Now in next bracket, a square means the value of a is sin square theta. A square means what? Sin square theta whole square a square. Okay, plus b square means what? Cos square theta whole square b square. Okay, minus a into b. A means sin square theta, b means cos square theta, means sin square theta into cos square theta. Now let's see. Dear student, we know that the value of sin square theta plus cos square theta is 1. So here this is the identity, is sin square theta plus cos square theta. So we can write 1 into in another bracket. Now let's see. We also know that a square plus b square, we can write a plus b whole square minus 2ab. So again here we using identity in that terms. This is the form of a means sin square theta and b means cos square theta, and this is the form of a square plus b square. So we can write a plus b whole square means a means sin square theta plus cos square theta whole square minus 2ab. Minus 2 into a means sin square theta, b means cos square theta, and minus sin square theta into cos square theta, right, as it is. Okay, now we know that the value of sin square theta plus cos square theta is 1, and this is sin square theta and this is also sin square theta, both are the like terms. These two the like terms now, and so we have this is 1, so we can write 1 minus
This is the form 2 sin square theta cos square theta minus 1 sin square theta cos square theta. So this is minus 3. This is 3 sin square theta into cos square theta. This is right hand side. This is the our result, na? Hence proved that result. Okay. Thus, dear students, in this way, you can solve each and every question of your NCERT exercise based on trigonometric identities in this way. This is one of the most important questions. So please, dear students, do more and more practices of that type of questions. Now, we take and solve some other important questions related to that topic. Let's see. Let's see, dear friends. The next question is: this is a very important question. If cos theta plus sine theta is equal to under root 2 cos theta. Show that cos theta minus sine theta is equal to under root 2 sine theta. This is a very important question, dear students, of your syllabus. So please do more and more practices of that type of question. Let's see. Our question is, we have cos theta plus sine theta. The value of cos theta plus sine theta is what? Under root 2 cos theta. And we have to show that cos theta minus sine theta is equal to under root 2 sine theta. Okay, now let's see. First of all, we have cos theta plus sin theta is equal to under root 2 cos theta. Under root 2 cos theta. Now, what I do in next step? Now, squaring both sides. Let's see. Now, squaring both sides. We get? Let's see. We get as cos theta plus sin theta whole square is equal to under root 2 cos theta whole square. Okay. Now what I get? Let's see. Here we write, we expand it based on the identity a plus b whole square. This is a square plus b square plus this is 2. A into D is equal to, this is what? This is 2, because of under root 2 square is what? 2. And this is cos square theta. 2 cos square theta. Now we have what? Cos square theta sin square theta transfer that side. So we get, this is 2 cos square theta plus cos square theta transfer that side. So we get minus cos square theta. And plus sin square theta transfer that side, we get minus sin square theta and is equal to 2 sin theta into cos theta is left. Okay. Now look, this is 2 cos square theta minus 1 cos square theta is what? We get only 1, because 2 minus 1 is 1. So we get 1 cos square theta, means we write as cos square theta minus sin square theta is equal to, this is 2 sin theta into cos theta. Okay. Now, let's see. This is the form of a square minus b square. Now, you here,
using the algebraic identities as what? A square minus b square, we can write a plus b into a minus b. So here a is what? Cos theta, and b is what? Sin theta. So we can write as cos theta plus sin theta in one bracket, and in another bracket cos theta minus sin theta, and is equal to, this is 2, this is give, we take equation more, which is we have, we write 2 sin theta into cos theta. Okay, now using equation 1, according to equation 1, we write the value of cos theta plus sin theta as what? Under root 2 cos theta. So here this is the form of cos theta plus sin theta. So here we write what? Under root 2 cos theta. So here we write using equation 1, we write as what? Under root 2 cos theta, and into, we write cos theta minus sin theta as it is, and is equal to 2 sin theta cos theta rise as it is. Now let's see here. Now we have what? Cos theta minus sin theta is equal to 2 sin theta into cos theta upon under root 2 cos theta, transfer that side. So we get what? Under root 2 cos theta cancel to each other. So 2 sin theta upon under root 2. Now we must be multiply both the numerator and denominator by under root 2. So we get what? We get as what? 2 under root 2 sin theta upon 2. 2 cancel to each other. So we get what? Under root 2 sin theta. Thus we have what? Cos theta minus sin theta under root is equal to under root 2 sin theta, hence proved. Okay, so dear, in this way you can solve that type of question. This is one of the most important question of your syllabus. So please dear students, do more and more practices of that type of questions. After that you can solve each and every questions of your NCERT exercise based on this topic. Let's see what's more type. This is very important questions related to trigonometric identities. Let's see. First of all, we have a relation cos theta plus sin theta is equal to under root 2 cos theta. We take equation number 1, and we have to show that cos theta minus sin theta is equal to under root 2 sin theta. So for proving that result, first of all, taking square both side of equation 1, we get cos theta plus sin theta whole square is equal to under root 2 cos theta whole square. Now we expanded it by using the identity a plus b whole square. So this is a square plus b square plus 2ab is equal to 2 cos square theta. Now what I do, we don't write cos square theta plus sin square theta is equal to 1, because of we have to show that this result. So for that we write, we transfer cos square theta that side, and sin square theta also transfer that side. So we get 2 cos square theta minus sin square theta is equal to 2 sin theta into cos theta. Now let's see here. This is like term. So we get 1 cos square theta and minus 1 sin square theta is equal to 2 sin theta into cos theta. Now this is the form of a square minus b square. So we can write a plus b into a minus b. A plus b into a minus b is equal to 2 sin theta into cos theta. Now using equation 1, we know that the value of cos theta plus sin theta is equal to under root 2 cos theta. Now we put in them, now we transfer that side. So we get, after simplify them, we get the value of cos theta minus sin theta is equal to 2 upon under root 2 sin theta, because of cos theta was cancelled to each other. Now we multiply both the numerator and denominator by under root 2. So we get 2 under root 2 upon under root 2, that is 2. So 2 also cancel to each other, and we get under root 2 sin theta. So in this way we prove that result. Similarly, so please Jason, do more and more practices of that type of question. After that you can solve each and every question of your NCERT exercise based on this topic. Now we take and solve some other important questions based on these topics.
Now we take some important question based on trigonometry identities. Prove that tan theta plus sec theta minus 1, tan theta plus sec theta minus 1 upon tan theta minus sec theta plus 1 is equal to 1 plus sin theta upon cos theta.
Dear student, this is a very important question. This is a very important question, and that question is comes in board examination so many times. So let's see, it is very important question. Now let's see its solution. First of all, we take left hand side. So we have tan theta plus sec theta minus 1 upon tan theta minus sec theta minus 1. Okay, now what I do, that's why we know that the algebraic identity, we can write sec square theta. We know that sec square theta minus tan square theta is equal to 1. We know that. So here in numerator we replace 1 by using that identity. Let's see. So we can write as tan theta plus sec theta, and we can write 1 as sec square theta minus tan square theta upon tan theta minus sec theta plus 1. Okay, now look, now again here we using the algebraic identities a square minus b square. You know that the value of a square minus b square as a plus b into a minus b. So here we can write as minus, we can write a square minus b square in the form of a plus b into a minus b, means a plus b into a minus b, and in denominator we can write tan theta and sec theta plus 1. Now look, that's why in the numerator we take the common as tan theta plus sec theta, because of tan theta plus sec theta in that terms and in that term also, this is tan theta plus sec theta. So we take as common as tan theta plus sec theta. Okay, now in next bracket we get, here we left 1, here minus, and in that terms we have left sec theta minus tan theta is left. Okay, now in numerator we can write as it is, which is tan theta minus sec theta plus 1. Okay, now what I do, now we break the brackets. So we get, let's see, if we break the brackets, then we get tan theta plus sec theta in one bracket, and the 1 minus, this is 1 minus sec theta plus tan theta, because of minus minus converted into the plus. So we get 1 minus sec theta plus tan theta upon, in numerator we have tan theta minus sec theta plus 1. Now look, dear friends, this is 1 minus sec theta plus tan theta, this is also 1 minus sec theta plus tan theta. This value is same, so that terms, that whole terms cancel to each other. So we get what? We get only the value tan theta plus sec theta. Now we convert it into the sine and cosine, because of these terms cancel to each other. Now we can write tan theta as sine theta upon cos theta, and sec theta we can write 1 upon cos. Now we take cos theta as LCM, so here we get sin theta plus 1, thus we have 1 plus, we get 1 plus sin theta upon cos theta. This is your
RHS has proved. 1 plus sin theta s upon cos theta, this is your RHS. Okay, thus this is the question. This is very important question, dear student, based on trigonometric identities. So please, please, dear student, do more and more practices of that type of questions. After that, you complete your NCERT exercise. Now we take and solve some other important questions based on identities. Let's see. No. The question is, this is a very important question. If sec theta plus tan theta is equal to P, then show that P square minus 1 upon P square plus 1 upon is equal to sine theta. Now let's see its solution.
This is the very important questions related to the chapter identities, trigonometry. Now we have, let's just we write, we have the value of P is what? Sec theta plus tan theta. And we have to show that tan P square minus 1 upon P square plus 1 is equal to sin theta. So what I do for that? So now we take the left hand side of the given question. After that, we putting the values of P.
Now take LHS. Now take left hand side, which is what? P square minus 1 upon P square plus 1. Now putting, we put the value of P in this expression. Okay, so we get as sec theta plus tan theta whole square minus 1 upon this, in this we have put sec theta plus 1. Okay, now what I do? Now here we using the identity a plus b whole square, and in both the numerator and denominator, and we expanded them. So we can write as a square plus b square plus 2ab means 2 sec theta tan theta, and minus 1 write as it is. Okay, and in denominator we can write, again we expanded them, a square plus b square plus 2ab and plus 1 write as it is.
Okay, now what I do? Let's see.
Dear friends, we know that the identities, since we know that 1 plus tan square theta is equal to what? Sec square theta, and sec square theta minus 1 is equal to tan square theta. So in numerator we arrange sec square theta minus 1 take together, sec square theta minus 1 take together, and plus tan square theta and plus 2 sec theta tan theta write as it is. And in denominator we can write 1, we take 1 plus tan square theta take together. Okay, so we have as sec square theta plus 1 plus tan square theta take together in denominator, and plus this is 2 sec theta into tan theta write as it is. Now
using that trigonometric identities, we can write sec square theta minus 1 as what? Tan square theta, and this is 1 plus tan square theta as what? Sec square theta. So we have what? This is tan square theta. So here we can have tan square theta. This is 2 tan square theta in numerator, and this is plus 2 sec theta into tan theta. And in the denominator, this is sec square theta, that is 2 sec square theta plus 2 sec theta into tan theta. Now, we take 2 tan theta in, as common in from numerator, so 2 tan theta as common. So, we get tan theta plus sec theta is left, and in denominator, we take 2 sec theta as common. So, we get sec theta plus tan theta. Now, look here, tan theta plus sec theta cancel to each other. So, and 2, 2 also cancel to each other. So, we get what? We get only tan theta upon sec theta. Now, we convert into the sine and cosine. So, we write sine tan theta as what? Sine theta upon cos theta, and sec theta is 1 upon cos theta. Now, cos cancel to each other. So, we get only sine theta. This is our right hand's proved. Okay. So, this is the method, dear students, to solve that type of question. So, please, dear students, do more and more practices of that type of questions. After that, you can solve each and every questions of your NCERT exercise based on the topic trigonometric identities. Now, we take and solve one more question based on this topic. Let's see. And the question is prove that, this is, we take a very important question of your NCERT exercise. Prove that under root 1 plus sine a upon 1 plus sine a upon 1 minus sine a is equal to sec a plus tan a. Sec a plus tan a. This is the very important question. Okay, now let's see its solution. First of all, we take the left hand side, which is what? Under root 1 plus sine a upon 1 minus sine a. Dear students, in all that type of questions, we just rationalizing them. Means in that type of question, we multiply both the numerator and denominator by the conjugate of its denominator, and we simplify them. So let's see. The dear friend, the conjugate of its denominator is what? 1 plus sine a. So we multiply both the numerator and denominator by 1 plus sine a. So let's see. This is 1 plus sine a into 1 plus sine a upon 1 minus sine a, right as it is, into 1 plus sine a. Matlab, we multiply both the numerator and denominator by 1 plus sine a. So we get what? We get in under root 1 plus sine a, 1 plus sine a. This is, we can write 1 plus sine a whole square. And in denominator, this is the form of a minus b into a plus b. So we can write a square minus b square means 1 minus sine square. And you know that we write as 1 plus sine a whole square upon 1 minus sine square theta is what? Cos square theta. So we can write cos square a. Now we break. All the values comes from the cert. So 1 plus sine a upon cos a. Now what I do, we can write 1 upon cos a plus sine a upon cos a. 1, you know that 1 upon cos a is what? Sec a. So we can write sec a here. Plus sine upon cos, we can write tan a. So here we can write tan a. So this is what? Sec a plus tan a. This is our right hand. Okay, thus this is the method to solve that type of question. So please, dear friend, first of all, you revise and do more and more practices of all the question which we discuss in that class. Now in next class, Dear student, we take and solve some other important question of your the topic introduction to trigonometrics. Now, thanks to all.